Isn't it beautiful? The ocean, not the ship. I mean, the ship is cool too, but the ocean is just so massive, and it's still very mysterious. Oh, and the ship? The ship is named Falkor. It's a research vessel from the Schmidt Ocean Institute, and aboard are scientists from institutions all over the world working hard to understand what's happening deep below. This expedition in the Gulf of California, we're looking at the mysteries of hydrothermal vents, using some of the latest technological advances aboard the ship to see into the deep, including Falkor's underwater robot, ROV Sebastian. I say we, but I'm not on board. I'm Brittany, a Schmidt Ocean Institute science communications intern in Brooklyn.
We are the only planet known to man that has liquid water at the surface.
That's Ronald Speltz Madero, a co-chief scientist aboard Falkor for the expedition in Mexico. He's a professor and a researcher at the Universidad Autónoma de Baja California. Today, we consider what scientists have learned in the past 45 years since discovering hydrothermal vents and why they're important. So what exactly is a hydrothermal vent? Over a mile and a half below the ocean's surface, hydrothermal vents form in volcanically active areas in the deep sea. This happens at the edge of spreading tectonic plates. In these areas, the Earth's crust can be thin above the mantle. The mantle lies between the Earth's dense, superheated core and the slim layer outside, the crust. Between the tectonic plates, mid-ocean ridges form a new crust as magma is pushed upwards. This new crust has cracks or fissures in it, where seawater seeps down into the planet and is warmed to really high temperatures by rocks that is heated by the magma underneath. The fluid, now rich in sulfide, methane, manganese, iron, and hydrogen, becomes more buoyant than seawater, and it travels up from the deep crust towards the ocean through these hydrothermal vents that are created by those minerals within the fluid. They solidify during contact with the cold seawater and act as a geyser or pipes for more fluid to flow. Some are as tall as 18 stories high, and there are vent fields that may remain active for over 10,000 years. Many individual vents have a short lifespan of only a few decades. If the existence of hydrothermal vents weren't cool enough, the discovery of hydrothermal vents in 1977 found more than just the vents themselves.
It was a geological expedition, and they were amazed because this happened east of the Galapagos Island near the equator. They didn't expect to find this amazing collection of ecological communities. That's what makes science exciting. The discovery of new things that we do not know that they're gonna be there.
There are whole ecosystems that live and thrive around these vents,